Welcome to Power Electronics Lecture Series. In this session, I'll be going to explain single phase bridge inverter. And in this single phase bridge inverter, I'll be explaining circuit working as well as waveform to complete this session regarding this full bridge inverter. Now here one can clearly see this inverter, that is a basic circuit which converts DC signal into AC signal, and this is what bridge, full bridge circuit, where T1, T2, T3, T4, SCR, that is getting triggered by giving gate pulse IG1, IG2, IG3, IG4, and this diode D1, D2, D3, D4 that has been utilized to have a passing of damped current. So I'll explain how damped current is passing through diode D1, D2, D3, D4. If we see this circuit functions basically in four different modes. So I'll explain each of four modes, how it functions. But before that, let us try to understand how this circuit basically functions. So this circuit functions based on SCR triggering. And here commutation circuits are considered as an ideal circuit, which is not shown over here. But consider if I say T1 as T2 is on, at that time T3 and T4 is off. And if I say T3 and T4 is on, then T1 and T2 will get off at the same time. So that is what the case which will happen. Now over here, what I'll be doing is I'll be triggering T1 and T2 at the same time. So if I trigger T1 and T2 at the same time, this plus that will appear at this terminal, and this minus that will appear at this terminal. So we'll be having terminal A and terminal B, where terminal A is positive with respect to terminal B when we will be triggering T1 and T2. If we trigger T3 and T4, then this plus that will appear at this end and this minus that will appear at this end. So B will be positive with respect to A. So we can say this B is positive with respect to A. Hence, negative voltage is appearing at the load. So that is how the circuit functions. If T1, T2 triggers, voltage will be plus V at output side. And if T3, T4 triggers, voltage will be minus V at output side. So let us initiate this functioning and then we'll see it's working then after. So over here we are triggering T1 and T2 at the same time, and as per that T1 and T2 triggering, voltage will be positive. So plus V voltage that will be appearing at the load side. And as T3, T4 triggers, over here, output voltage that will be minus Vs. And if we keeps on repeating this, T1, T2 triggers at this instant, then there will be plus V voltage, and at this instant, if we trigger T3 and T4, then there will be minus V voltage that will appear at output side. So if our load is resistive load, voltage and current waveform will be having same shape, and current will pass through T1 and T2 in case of T1 and T2 is getting triggered, and current will pass through T3 and T4 in case of T3, T4 triggers, and there is nothing to do with D1, D2, D3, D4 in case of resistive load. But if our load is RL load. So here we have RL load. So in case of RL load, current that will increase like this, and as negative cycle comes, current will decrease like this. During positive cycle, current will increase like this, and during negative cycle, current will decrease like this. So here one can clearly see, in case of RL load, this is what output current I0, and this is what output voltage V0. Now what happens here? When we trigger T1 and T2, but here current is negative, here current is negative and voltage is positive. So because of that, current is negative and voltage is positive, during this instant, from, let us say this is T0, let us say this is T1. So during T0 to T1, diode D1 and D2 is activated, and current will be supplied by a load. So ultimately current will flow in this loop. And it will flow through diode D1 and D2. So here I am writing, in between T0 to T1, diode D1 and D2 functions. Diode D1 and D2, that is functions, and current will be by load. So load current that flows. So here SCR current T1 and T2 will be 0 during T0 to T1, and one can see diode D1 and D2 current flows. So this is what diode D1 and D2, so this will be the current that will be flowing in this situation. So over here even there is a similar situation. So during that, this will be the current that will be flowing through diode D1 and D2. Now, during T1 to T2, so let us say this is where T2 is there. At the time voltage is positive and current is positive. So current will flow by supply. Current will flow by supply and it will flow through T1 and T2. So during T1 to T2, current will flow through supply, through load, through T2 like this. So current will flow through supply to T1, to load, to T2 like this. So T1 to T2, T1 to T2, current flows through T1 to T2 even. And this is what? Supply current. This is what? Supply current. And that is flowing through IT1 and IT2. So ultimately one can clearly see this is what the current that is what happening during T1 to T2. And here there is a similar case where current is passing through T1 and T2. Now, during time period T2 to T3, up to this instant, voltage is negative and current is positive. Voltage is negative and current is positive. So at this period, diode D3 and D4, that is getting activated, and current will be supplied by a load, and direction of current will be like this, through D3 to load to D4, and that is how current will flow. So T2 to T3, current is positive and voltage is negative. So current flows from D3 to load to D4 like this. And that is where current is being supplied by load. And at that time we have triggered T3 and T4. But current will not flow through T3 and T4. The reason is current is positive and voltage is negative. So at that time current will be supplied by load and it will pass through diode D3 and D4. So current will be through diode D3 and D4 like this. It will be negative across load. Sorry, current is positive, voltage is negative, and that will happen across load. And here this is where same situation that is happening like this. So one can say during T2 to T3, current passes through D3 and D4, and that is due to load current. Now during T3 to T4, voltage is negative, current is negative, so that will be supplied by supply. And that will pass through T3 and T4. So during T3 to T4, current and voltage both are negative. That current will be supplied by supply and it will pass from T4 to load to T3 like this. So direction will be like this. So it will pass through T4 to load to T3 and it will pass like this, and that will be passing through T3 and T4. So here current will flow from T3 and T4 like this during time period T3 to T4, and that is how it flows. So here during T3 to T4, current passes through SCR T3 and T4, and that is due to supply current. So that is how there are four modes which I have explained you. During T0 to T1, current passing through diode D1 and D2, and that is happening because of load current, and this is because of damped situation. Here RL load is connected, so there will be a damped current. And that damped current will be passing through diode D1, D2 during positive voltage and D3, D4 during negative voltage. So four modes of operations are there. Damped current is passing through D1, D2 during positive and D3, D4 during negative voltage situation. And supply current that will be there during voltage and current that is positive and voltage and current that is negative, that happens for T1, T2 during T1 to T2 period over here, and during T3 to T4 period, negative voltage, negative current is there, and that has been supplied by voltage. And that is how we will be having output voltage, which is AC, and that is what we can have it by having controlling of this full bridge inverter circuit. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, then like button, and if you dislike video, then dislike should be praised. But in case of you dislike this video, please give suggestions so that I can improve upon in next videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.